You're at 446-69-448-87 DeQuinder Road, Troy, Michigan.
Dealing with flat tire. Delays on going to the work. Westbound 696 from Farmington to Novi Road. North and south on I-75 between Clay and Finnish. The right lane closure continues through next Friday. And the work continues here. Westbound I-94, that ramp to southbound in 10, remains closed as well. Your next traffic update coming up at 1:18 from the Vans Lumber and Mill Work Traffic Center.
It will be a hot afternoon with sunshine and a breeze. A high getting up to 90. The humidity's down a bit. Shower thunderstorm this evening and partly cloudy down in the upper 60s tonight. A little bit sticky tomorrow. It's hot again up near 90. It's more humid and feeling hot on Saturday as we get up to near 90. And another day, upper 80s to near 90 Sunday. Very warm and humid with thunderstorms, especially late in the day. That front should knock down the humidity for Monday as we're back in the low to mid 80s with some sunshine. I'm Mackie with meteorologist Dean DeVore, WWJ News Radio 950.
We're at 88 degrees now at Detroit's Metro Airport, 89 in Canton, and 86 in Rochester Hills. Wind is west at 11 at Metro. The humidity is at 40% and the skies are partly cloudy. Updates of traffic and weather together every 10 minutes on the 8s around the clock. Our next update is less than 10 minutes away at 1:18. WWJ News Time, 1:10. Haley Stevens has taken the lead in a new poll on the hotly contested congressional Democratic primary in Oakland County.
It's the only new congressional district that has two incumbent members of Congress battling each other. But a new poll by Target Insight has Haley Stevens with a 58% lead over Andy Levin's 31%, only 11% undecided. Ed Sarpolis, who conducted the poll, says it will be hard to beat Stevens.
The only area where there's a very big competition going on is in the southeast corner of Oakland County, and you know that whole Ferndale and Royal Oak area, which is really just the heart of Levin's base, but he's actually tied there. So if you can't win in your own backyard, it's very difficult to beat Haley Stevens, who basically has represented the western portion of this this new district.
And Sarpolis says that the pro-Israel group AIPAC is supporting Stevens over Levin. That's the difference. Charlie Knight, WWJ News Radio 950.
Well, after the pandemic, maybe all the construction in Ann Arbor is no big deal for those who put on the Ann Arbor Art Fair. People from all over the metro area are in Ann Arbor for this year's festival. They're enjoying the sights and sounds, and our WWJ's Ryan Marshall is there, and he joins us live with more.
Well, good afternoon to you, Mike, and it is a beautiful day out here. The Ann Arbor Art Fair is back in downtown Ann Arbor from today until Saturday. 500,000 people expected over the three-day fair. They'll be greeted by nearly 1,000 artists across 30 blocks showcasing their work. One of those artists is Thomas LaGault of Plymouth. He's a master artist, in fact, with his own personal studio. He says he's been coming to this fair, Mike, since 1971. He says he didn't even have a driver's license then.
It's pretty much got the same kind of energy and enthusiasm. It's a big show. I do a lot of smaller events up in Charlevoix and Harbor Springs, but this is a big city thing that I can come to and showcase some of the works that I have.
Now, Mike, there's some great work out here, in fact, in the form of photographs, paintings, drawings, pottery, crafts, among others. And there's also live music on three stages. It is a great event down here. First time I've ever been, so I'm going to take in some of the sights and sounds out here in downtown Ann Arbor. We're in Ann Arbor. I'm Ryan Marshall, WWJ News Radio 950.
Thank you, Ryan. We'll update traffic and weather together coming up at 1:18. At 1:15 here on News Radio 950, Ford is talking about some layoffs and some investment in EVs, kind of linked topics. Our AutoBeat reporter, Jeff Gilbert, will have some details for us coming up at 1:15, just 2 minutes from now.
Men of all ages, shockwave therapy and the conventional ED pills are ineffective and not safe for all men. But there's good news. After just one simple visit to Male Method, you will no longer have to worry about performing in the bedroom. Our medical solution is an alternative to wave therapy and pills that we guarantee will provide a safe and positive result on a single office visit, right in our office, or it won't cost you one penny. At Male Method, we've helped thousands of men get back in the game. We get you the solution you want the same day, right in our office, or there's no charge.
WWJ News Time's now 1:16. Coming up on News Radio 950, we still have trouble out there on the roadways. Our Tracy McCaskill has the update for us coming up at 1:18. Coming up at 1:23, we're going to check in with our Chris Villar for sports.
The Tigers are back and set to play a pair. Previewing their matchup out west, sports is next.
WWJ News Time's 1:16. Possibility the Townsend Hotel in Birmingham is going to be sold. It might have a new owner already. Sheldon Yellen is reportedly buying the Townsend Hotel. The cost of the sale has not been released. Townsend's known for hosting stars when they come to town, like Paul McCartney, and visiting basketball teams. Yellen is the CEO of Belfour Property Restoration. Made an appearance on the CBS TV show Undercover Boss. Word is that he will keep the hotel a hotel. Ford says it's on track to be able to make 600,000 EVs annually by next year, stepping that up to 2 million by the middle of the decade.
To do that, Ford Vice President Lisa Drake says they've assembled material and batteries and are looking at a new lower-cost battery technology called lithium ion phosphate, or LFP.
You know, we know that the battery material cost is where the war will be won in the short term. And by far, LFP chemistry will give you the biggest step function down in that material cost.
Drake wouldn't comment on reports of coming job cuts, but did say that smaller teams can move faster than a larger team. Jeff Gilbert, WWJ, Freddie Gellin, News is Day.
WWJ News Time is 1:17. We have some power outages in Metro Detroit that are still being worked on. A wind gust of 66 miles an hour reported at Metro Airport yesterday afternoon. DTE says about 4,000 homes and businesses still don't have electricity. One of the major areas is near Pelham and Champaign and Allen Park. Wind damage also causing an outage near 11 Mile in Farmington and Farmington Hills. In Sterling Heights, an equipment problem has knocked out power to about 1,500 people. That's near 60 Mile in Shaner. Power is expected to be restored later today. Coming up on News Radio 950 after we check traffic and weather together, Starbucks workers continue to try to unionize, this time in Mount Pleasant. We'll have the update for you coming up. WWJ News Time is 1:18. That's time for our update on the roads, and here is Tracy McCaskill.
And this report sponsored by Joel Shipery Allstate Agency. Checking the AAA GM camps here. Still watching a crash along westbound I-94 after Mount Elliott. Right shoulder blocked. Traffic is slower from Van Dyke to Shane there. The large pothole still a factor. A number of motorists had to deal with flat tires maneuvering along westbound 696 near Greenfield. That pothole in the right center lane. In Sterling Heights, Mound Road still affected both ways here between DeQuinder and M59. Heavier traffic due to that work. 15 or 17 mile, your best alternate. Time now for the NECA IBEW Local 58 construction alert. We have the work ongoing here, US 23 northbound from Thompson to 75, and southbounders delayed here from I-75 to US 23 there. As well, a stalled semi northbound 275 just before the M-596 split. Traffic is slower from 9 Mile. We're monitoring that on ways as well. And delays ongoing 696 westbound forward from Farmington to Novi Road. You're in good hands with Northville Allstate agent Joel Shimbury. For a free insurance review, call Joel Shimbury 734-927-9500 today. I'll have your next traffic update here at 1:28 from the Man's Lumber and Millwork Traffic Center.
And now we get the AccuWeather forecast from the Bill Brown Ford Weather Center.
Hot, breezy, and a little bit less humid this afternoon. So we'll get up to around 90. We'll be seeing a shower thunderstorm in spots this evening. Partly cloudy, down to 68 tonight. A couple of more days near 90 tomorrow with the humidity up, and even 90 on Sunday is not out of the question with some late-day thunderstorms that'll knock the stuffing out of this heat and humidity by Monday. I'm AccuWeather meteorologist Ian DeVore, WWJ News Radio 950.
88 degrees and partly cloudy at Metro, west wind at 11 and humidity at 40%. 87 degrees in Westland and in Traverse City currently. Updates of traffic and weather together every 10 minutes on the 8s around the clock. Our next update is less than 10 minutes away at 1:28. WWJ News Times 1:20. Workers at a Starbucks location in Mount Pleasant are petitioning for a union election. Workers United says an overwhelming majority of workers at the store signed authorization cards after baristas at 10 other Starbucks locations in Michigan filed for and won union elections. Hundreds of other locations throughout the country have also signed up to unionize in states like Tennessee and Illinois. A victory for all workers This is how an advocacy group for restaurant workers classifies a court ruling that overturned legislative changes made in 2018 to two petitions that were approved by state voters. The Michigan Court of Claims says the adopt and amend tactic of the then Republican-led legislature contradicted the will of the people to raise Michigan's minimum wage to $12 an hour by 2022. Instead, the legislature raised it gradually to $12.05 an hour by 2030, delaying the full amount by 8 years. Chris White of the Restaurant Opportunity Center says the vindication is especially satisfying after the pandemic year.
In many ways, restaurant workers, they risked their life. They became essential workers because regardless of what was happening through this horrific time, we still needed to eat. And those restaurant workers risked their lives.
White says the ROC is preparing for but doesn't expect pushback on the minimum wage issue for most restaurant workers because most of them make over $12 an hour now. Not so for the second petition that was overturned here. That one would have paid sick leave to workers across the board, but as was limited by the legislature, the ROC says that change affected around 1.9 million workers in the state. Coming up on News Radio 950, an update on sports at 123. WWJ News Time, 122.
Radio, we'll be en route to Kroger to play Honda.
This is Rachel Hurst, Corporate Affairs Manager with Kroger Michigan. So excited to announce a special partnership with Kroger and local first responders for the Kroger Zero Hunger Emergency Food Drive. Right, Chief?
We will have over 50 law enforcement agencies collecting non-perishable food donations for families in need at select Kroger stores.
When school is out, many children go hungry. Help us fill a patrol vehicle with food donations to feed hungry children across the state.
Please donate on July 30th and August 6th. Visit WWJNewsRadio.com/FeedMish for a list of participating Kroger stores. Backed up sink or shower? Clogged toilet or basement drain? No need to be afraid.